बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। दिस इज़ लेक्चर नंबर 7 ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 3। इन द चैप्टर नंबर 3 इज स्टेट्स ऑफ मैटर। दिस इज़ वेरी इजी चैप्टर। इन द मोस्ट ऑफ द टॉपिक्स आर वेरी इजी बिकॉज यू आर फेमिलियर विद द स्टेट्स ऑफ मैटर, सॉलिड, लिक्विड एंड गैस। द इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स ऑफ दिस चैप्टर आर कॉमन स्टेट्स ऑफ मैटर, काइनेटिक डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ स्टेट्स ऑफ मैटर, सॉलिड स्टेट ऑफ मैटर, लिक्विड स्टेट ऑफ मैटर, गैशियस स्टेट ऑफ मैटर, इंटर कन्वर्शन ऑफ थ्री स्टेट ऑफ मैटर, ब्राउनियन मूवमेंट, आइसोटोप, रेडियो एक्टिविटी। दिस इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग पिक्चर। In this picture, you can see different states of matter: solid, liquid, gas, and plasma. Up till now, we have read about the three basic or major states of matter, that are solid, liquid and gas. But now, the fourth state of matter, that is known as plasma, has been discovered. Now, what is plasma? Basically, plasma is a mixture of negative and positive charge. And how these negative and positive charges are formed? This is formed by heating. At very high temperature, most of the atoms, they lose their electrons, and after losing the electrons, they become positive nuclei. Now, this mixture of electrons which carry negative charge and nuclei which carry positive charge. You can see this mixture of negative and positive charges in this diagram, the last one. So, this mixture of negative and positive charge is known as plasma. This is the fourth state of matter. Properties of solids. Solids have definite shape and volume because their particles are tightly packed. They have only back and forth motions, means they cannot move, they cannot leave their places because they are very tightly packed. And due to this tightly packing, intermolecular spaces are very small. There is no space between the molecules, and due to this, intermolecular forces are very high because they are very close to each other, so they have very high attractive forces. And due to this compact packing, density of the solid is generally high. They are very dense and compact packed, and they are rigid. And due to this, melting point and boiling point of solid is high. Liquid state. Properties of liquid. Liquids have no definite shapes and volume. They acquire the shape of the container. Molecules are not tightly packed. And why? They don't have definite shape and volume because their molecules are not tightly packed. They can easily move. That is why they change their shapes. Intermolecular space is larger than solids. As the molecules are at a distance, so they have a much better space or much greater space than solid. And intermolecular forces of attraction is less than the solid because the distance is present. Or space is present, that is why they have less force of attraction among them. Density of the liquid is less than solid. Melting point and boiling point is less as compared to solids. So all the properties are depending on the arrangement or force of attraction between the molecules. So they are interlinked with each other. And that is why the properties of solid, liquid and gases are different from each other. Gaseous state. Properties of gases. glasses have no definite shape and volume. Why? Because molecules are very far from each other. They can easily move from one place to another place. And due to this distance, intermolecular forces are negligible because they are at very large distance. That is why they don't have any attractive forces among them. Density of gases are extremely small as compared to solid and liquid. Kinetic energy of molecules are very high. Why kinetic energy of molecules are very high? Because they have much space to move. And gases are easily compressed. Again, the reason is that we can compress them because there is too much space between the molecules. That is why they can be compressed. Melting and boiling point of gases are less as compared to solid and liquid. Change of state of matter. Matters can be easily changed from one form to another form. Or we can say state of matters are interconvertible by applying heat and pressure. Now, there are two examples that what happens when a solid is heated and what happens when a liquid is heated. So, first, solid. When heat is applied to a solid, then the solid particles, they become more energetic by absorbing heat energy. As they have no space, so they start vibrational or translational movement. And with the passage of time, when they become more energetic, then these particles, they start moving fast. And by doing this, the force of attraction between these particles will decrease. And as the force of attraction will decrease, then they will leave their position and arrangement. And when they will leave their position and arrangement, then they will turn into liquid. Means solid particles को जब हमने heat किया वो इतने ज़्यादा energetic हो गए कि उनको उनके पास space नहीं थी, उन्होंने move करना शुरू कर दिया और move करते करते वो एक वक्त ऐसा आएगा कि वो अपनी position, force of attraction उनकी decrease हो जाएगी और वो फिर अपनी position और arrangement को छोड़ देंगे and they will convert into liquid form. And what happens when a liquid is heated? Same procedure जो है वो liquid में भी होता है. Liquid on heating, the molecules become more energetic and they start moving upward and they will reach at the top of the surface of the liquid. And upon heating, more heating, they will leave the surface of the liquid. They will burst into vapors or gaseous form. And in this way, a liquid on heating is converted into gaseous form. A simple presentation in which interconversion of the three state of matter has been shown. So, solid into liquid and liquid into gas. Only this is possible by applying heat. A solid is converted into liquid and then on applying heat, liquid is converted into gaseous form. Evaporation. This is a scientific process in which escape of water molecules from the surface of liquid takes place. It takes place at all temperature, but it increases with the rise of temperature. So we can see the example. There are two examples in which in one example the water is evaporating from a pond. This pond is not being heated, so evaporation is taking place in the presence of sunlight. Or if there is no sunlight, then the process is continued but it becomes slow. On the other hand, the kettle is being heated, so after heating the water vapors are escaping very fast in the form of steam. So this is known as evaporation. Another example from daily life, that when we hang the wet clothes, so it's not necessary that sunlight they will dry in the presence of sunlight. Even when there is no sunlight, then it becomes dry, but the process of evaporation becomes slow. So evaporation takes place at all temperature. Sublimation. Sublimation is another scientific process in which a solid is directly converted into fumes or gas without heating. Or we can define sublimation as a process in which a solid is directly converted into gas without heating. There are two examples. The first example is of dry ice. You can see the fumes which are coming out of dry ice. Now after some time, these dry ice will disappear and there will be no liquid. It means this dry ice has been converted into gas. Another example is of naphthalene balls. So these naphthalene balls, normally we use these naphthalene balls to protect our warm clothes from termites. So after a year, when we take out these naphthalene balls, the size most of the time they disappear, or the size of the naphthalene balls decreases. So it means these naphthalene balls have been converted into fumes. So you can do this experiment at home. Take two or three balls and just keep them aside and watch them after a week. Then you will find the visible change between the size of these balls after a week. So this process is known as sublimation. Diffusion in gases, or Graham's law of diffusion. Now what is the meaning of diffusion? The simple meaning is movement of particle is known as diffusion. But in terms of chemistry, the process of spreading of particles of liquid and gases as a result of their spontaneous movement is known as diffusion. So Graham was the first person who noticed about the diffusion, and he worked on this and he formulated a law that is known as Graham's law of diffusion. According to Graham, rate of diffusion is inversely proportional to the square root of their density. It means if the particles are dense or heavy, then the rate of diffusion will be less. And if the particles are lighter in weight, then they will diffuse easily. Greater the density, lesser the diffusion. And he found that in solid, there is no diffusion. Because the solid particles, they are tightly packed. They are unable to move from one place to another place. That is why there is no diffusion in solid. But in case of liquid, the diffusion is very fast as compared to other solid substances. Why? Because in liquid the particles are free to move from one place to another place, and that is why they diffuse easily. Now you can see the example of a bottle in which some crystals of potassium permanganate are dropped, and without stirring these particles are the color they will diffuse, and after a few minutes the color of the bottle will be changed into dark purple. This is by the diffusion of potassium permanganate crystals. In case of gas, the diffusion is very fast. And the reason is that in gases, the particles have much space to move from one place to another place, and they are lighter in weight. That is why they diffuse very fast, quickly, due to their movement. The best example is the spreading of perfumes. When you open the bottle of perfume in a room, immediately you can smell the smell of the perfume at the other corner of the room within no time. So this is the best example of diffusion of gas. Brownian movement. This property was first time observed by a British botanist, Robert Brown, in 1827. During the movement of pollen grain in water by microscope. So the statement of this movement is that a continuous rapid zigzag or irregular movement of suspended particles through the medium is called Brownian movement. Now what is suspended particles? Means the particles which are not dissolved in a solution. वो पार्टिकल जो सोल्यूशन में डिसॉल्व नहीं होते उनको हम कहते हैं सस्पेंडेड पार्टिकल. फॉर एग्जांपल, व्हाट ही डिड, ही मिक्स सम सल्फर पाउडर इन वाटर and stir it. After stirring, he filtered the solution, and then he took one or two drops from this filtered solution and put it on the under the microscope to observe the movement of the sulfur particle. And he found that sulfur particle were moving in rapidly moving in zigzag direction. Means their movement was very haphazard, not in a specific direction. Actually, what was happening? These sulfur particles, they were hitting by water molecules in one direction, and then other water molecule was hitting this sulfur molecule in other direction. In this way, the sulfur particle were moving in rapidly in zigzag direction. Actually, according to molecular theory, water molecules are always in motion, and they collide or they strike with the sulfur particle, and they push them in some direction where they collide with other water molecules, and they push them in other direction. In this process, a continuous rapid zigzag motion is taking place. Now I am explaining it in Urdu. Brownian movement, actually Brownian was a scientist. Brownian scientist था जिसने pollen grain को की movement को water molecules के साथ observe किया था. उसने ये देखा कि pollen grain जो है वो बहुत rapidly zigzag direction में move कर रहे हैं. तो उसने ये observe किया कि ये pollen grain क्यों rapidly zigzag direction में move कर रहे हैं. तो उससे ये find out किया कि water molecules जो है वो हमेशा move कर रहे हैं. तो जब भी कोई चीज़ उसके अंदर डिजॉल्व होती है, जो सस्पेंशन बनाएगी, सस्पेंडेड होंगे, तो वाटर मॉलिक्यूल्स उनको हिट करेंगे एक डायरेक्शन में, फिर दूसरा वाटर मॉलिक्यूल उसको दूसरे डायरेक्शन में हिट करेगा, तीसरा वाटर मॉलिक्यूल उसको तीसरे डायरेक्शन में हिट करेगा, क्योंकि सारे वाटर मॉलिक्यूल्स जो हैं वो मूव कर रहे हैं, दे आर इन कंटिन्यूस मूवमेंट. सो इस तरह से वो जो भी चीज़ सस्पेंडेड होगी वो रैपिडली मूव करेगी zigzag डायरेक्शन में. मींस उसकी मूवमेंट haphazard होगी, उसको हर तरफ से वाटर मॉलिक्यूल्स, कोई ना कोई वाटर मॉलिक्यूल हिट करेगा. इस तरह की मूवमेंट को हम कहते हैं ब्राउनियन मूवमेंट. रेडियो एक्टिविटी. द प्रोसेस ऑफ रेडियो एक्टिविटी वॉज ऑब्जर्व बाय अ साइंटिस्ट हेनरी बेक्यूरर. Definition: the process of spontaneous disintegration of the nucleus by emitting invisible radiations is known as radioactivity, and the elements which emit these type of rays are known as radioactive elements. They emit three types of rays: alpha rays, beta rays and gamma rays. Now the question is that which elements are radioactive elements and why this process takes place. Now the answer is that in most of the cases, the elements having greater atomic number or greater than 82 atomic number, the nucleus of these elements are unstable. There is a force which are holding the protons and neutrons in the nucleus. So as the number becomes high, greater number, this force which is holding proton and neutrons together becomes weak, and due to this the nucleus of the element becomes unstable. Now to make it stable, these atoms, they will emit radiations from their nucleus, and in this way they will become stable. यानी वो elements जिनके atomic masses 82 या उनसे ज़्यादा होते हैं, in most of the cases वो unstable होते हैं, क्योंकि एक special force होती है जो कि proton और neutron को एक साथ रखती है nucleus में. जब इतना ज़्यादा heavy atomic number हो जाता है, atomic mass हो जाता है, तो वो force weak हो जाती है जो proton और neutron को bind कर रही है. ठीक है, जब ये फोर्स वीक हो जाएगी तो उनका न्यूक्लियस अनस्टेबल हो जाता है. जब न्यूक्लियस अनस्टेबल होगा तो वो अपने आप को स्टेबल करने के लिए रेज इमिट करेंगे. ठीक है, वो रेज जिनको हम अल्फा रेज, बीटा रेज एंड गामा रेज करते हैं, जब ये रेज निकलती हैं उनमें से, तो फिर ये एलिमेंट्स अपने आप को स्टेबल कर लेते हैं, और इस प्रोसेस को हम कहते हैं रेडियो एक्टिविटी. रेडियो एक्टिविटी. This is a very simple picture in which nucleus of the atom has been shown. and proton and neutrons are representing by different colors, blue and red color. So the three type of rays which are emitting from this nucleus is alpha radiations or alpha rays. It is made up of two protons and two neutrons. Second, beta rays. They are high energy electrons, means the weight of these beta rays will be negligible like electrons because they are high energy electrons. And the third is gamma rays. Gamma radiations are very high energy electromagnetic photons. So we can see in the second picture that alpha particles are stopped by the sheet of paper, means alpha particles are heavy particles, so they can be stopped by a sheet or by a paper, means they cannot pass from this sheet or paper. Beta particles, they are stopped by a layer of clothing or by few millimeter of a substance such as aluminium. Means beta particles ko hum aluminium ya few centimeter ke substance se bhi hum rok sakte hain. But the third type of rays, gamma rays, which are very high electromagnetic photons or electromagnetic rays, it cannot be stopped. It passes several feet of concrete or few inches of lead. It means that they are very high energetic rays. Ye concrete ki wall se bhi pass ho jate hain few centimeter tak. So these are the nature and types of radioactive rays. Isotopes. Atom of the same element having same atomic number but different atomic masses are known as isotopes. Why atomic mass is different? Because they have different number of neutrons in the nucleus. Atomic number is same, means number of electrons and number of proton is always equal, but number of neutron is different. That is why mass number is changed. I have taken three examples. There are so many isotopes, but I have taken three examples. The first one is hydrogen. There are three isotopes of hydrogen: hydrogen 1, hydrogen 2, and hydrogen 3. Normally, hydrogen 1 is called protium, hydrogen 2 is called deuterium, and hydrogen 3 is called tritium. In hydrogen 1, there is only one proton in the nucleus. In hydrogen 2, there is one proton and one neutron, and in hydrogen 3, there is one proton and two neutrons. But number of electron in each hydrogen is one. Same is the case with the isotopes of oxygen. There are three isotopes of oxygen: oxygen 16, oxygen 17, and oxygen 18. In each case, number of neutron is different. The third example is of chlorine. There are two isotopes, stable isotopes of chlorine, chlorine 35 and chlorine 37. Atomic number in each case is 17, but atomic mass is 35 and 37. So, due to difference in the atomic mass, they are called isotopes.